everybody, I'm in this game too. And he doesn't change the way that he plays. He doesn't overplay the position. You know, and that's a learned craft when you have a decisive edge like Carolina's had.
Featuring with it. The other thing you know is a goal kicker, not that it gets boring back there, but he doesn't force touches either. You know, wandering to go to try to play the bucket.
That is a learned craft. Detroit. Detroit, when they won the Stanley Cup, their first of their recent run of Stanley Cups in 97, Mike Vernon, a Hall of Famer now, won the Conn Smythe. Detroit was out playing teams, but he'd make those four or five great saves that allowed Detroit to eventually win that cup. That's why he was deserving of winning that Conn Smythe.
Carolina in 65 seconds will get a ticket punched for the sixth time to the NHL playoffs in a row, all under Rod Brind'Amour here.
He deserves such Goliath credit. And Rod would be the first one to say, hey, Tom Dundon gave us an equal playing field.
Yep.
Right from the get-go, salary cap team.
1 minute remaining in the
period. Being one of the truly elite coaches.
The Lionel charges after it is. We're in the final 50 seconds here of this third period. Carolina looking for their 25th win at home. And they've been a long drought. 0-9. Last time they were in the playoffs, and then Rod Brind'Amour takes over as coach. Tom Dundon, the majority owner. Six straight years in the playoffs. There's one thing left here to settle on the scoreboard, and Carolina hustling. What a play by Mason to make sure that Edmonton doesn't get there. Anderson's on the ice, and now a couple of players taking exception here. But the Canes selling out, but this is game one of a playoff series.
Where was it? Where is it now? It's a capacity crowd every night to watch this thing right to the finish line, and Anderson chasing you know what, and his teammates know that. And I feel major gratitude. You know, I just looked across the board just quickly. Burns, most recently Gensel, Kuznetsov, Brady Shea, some of the aggressive trades that Don Waddell has made that are paramount. What the Hurricanes have done to continue to build, and they're headed to the playoffs for the sixth consecutive year.
As something was thrown on the ice, so that'll stop.
Nobody would dare throw an octopus in these conditions.
Well, they did. They've chopped it up. Oh, it was. Little calamari, that's a little overdone.
Oh, it is.
No, oh, that is
an octopus.
Oh, yeah. Being a huge foodie, you are the octopus lover.
I've actually grown to really love octopus. But
yeah, they say you gotta boil them.
Very few of them here, but octopus not gonna age well if you take it home unless you get it on the grill right away.
You say you gotta sit through that for 2.5 hours. Well, sorry for the guy next to you. Canes fans take it home for a sixth straight time.
That have accomplished what Carolina has in the last 6 years. This should be celebrated. Players first and foremost, coaching staff, and the organization. What a job, what a privilege it is to be here in Carolina.
100%. The fans now know that the playoffs have been clinched here inside PNC Arena. The players know it. And as far as storm surge for the 25th time this year, we are treated to a storm surge from the Carolina Hurricanes.
Circle jerk moment.
Well,
the storm, sir. I'm just saying.
Well, with the win, the Carolina Owl House will donate $200 to the Carolina Hurricanes Foundation and the Points for Kids program. Thanks to the Carolina Owl House. And for the 46th time this year, the Owl House has made that $200 donation to the Carolina Hurricanes Foundation and the Points for Kids program. Well, you know what they say, March comes in like a lion, goes out like a lamb, while the Canes aren't going out like lambs right now. All that's left is Saturday night in Montreal. It'll be a 6:30 start with Hurricanes Live with Hanny Yates, 7 o'clock faceoff. For the Canes, this last stretch, a win against the Leafs, that tough loss against Pittsburgh, and a 4-0 win here tonight. Sebastian Aho, a big part of it, with a goal and two assists, 250 career goals, 301 career assists.
For the game, the Carolina Hurricanes, with a 24-save
since returning from his blood clotting issue.
John's just going to sit back and enjoy all this.
Get ready, folks. Your first star is Seth Jarvis. He's going to talk about his night, the Carolina Hurricanes making the playoffs for six straight seasons. All he's known is the postseason, as he's with our Hanny Yates.
Seth, a three-point night for you. Four goals from four different players on this team. Another shutout by Freddie Anderson. How would you describe the depth that was showcased by this group tonight?
Yeah, we did really good. Freddie played unreal again. I mean, he's been great since he came back, so it's nice to have that back there. And then just depth scoring has been a big piece for us.
With that win here tonight, this group clinches its sixth straight playoff appearance. Congratulations. That one feels nice to hear. What does that say about this franchise, the organization?
We're just looking for a little respect down here. We're a hockey city, everyone knows it, and now we're coming for the final goal.
You head out to Montreal tomorrow, still eight games remaining. What is the message and the mentality in the locker room to close out this season?
Finish strong. We want to go into playoffs on a heater, so we're looking to continue that tomorrow.
Thank you, Seth. Congratulations.
Thank you, Hannah.
This fan base loves Seth Jarvis, and as well they should. Well, tonight it was simple for Carolina. Come in, win the game, you punch your ticket to the playoffs. Jalen Chatfield serving notice with a big hit. And then the Canes blow this open in the second period with a 4-0 win. Coming up, Hurricanes Live, the postgame show. You'll hear from Ron Brindamore. We'll be back inside the Canes locker room. You'll get insight and analysis from Chip Tracy and Shane Willis. We'll have your game highlights and look ahead to Saturday's game in Montreal for the Canes going back to the playoffs with a 4-0 win.